guests at the dais, friends, colleagues, ladies and gentlemen. It's an honor that words cannot express, the privilege beyond compare to be amongst all of you and to be the guest of honor in this very pleasant meeting, in this Saturday evening. As you all know, India has, yesterday only our former president spoke, India is a land of multiple religions, multiple faiths. And we have number of festivals, and each of these festivals has its own significance. This holy month of Ramadan, which every Hyderabadi looks forward to. When I had first come to Hyderabad exactly 25 years back, that was the holy month of Ramadan. I was really fascinated. Morning I used to get up early in the morning at 4:30 a.m. get ready, go for a case, because I was working in a government hospital at 9 a.m. Morning I used to go and operate in various nursing homes in the entire city. I used to really, you know, enjoy so many people and the crowds, lighting, and the entire city is a festive look. And people come forward, go for prayers, small kids early in the morning at 5 a.m. they start going for prayers. And it was a really festive. In the evening when I come back from hospital home, it again used to be the same festive look. I was really fascinated those days, and now for past 25 years I got used to it. But this is the first time I'm ever invited for an iftar party like this. I'm thankful to the organizers. This divine fasting from the dawn to dusk, as you all know, which is the hallmark of this Ramadan, essentially implies complete abstinence from food, drinks or water. But it also teaches us to abstain from, as he has already, our organizers have already mentioned, it also teaches us to abstain. Do not lie, do not deceive, do not cheat, do not harm, do not indulge in unlawful activities, do not succumb to pleasure, do not instigate violence, and to be precise, stay away from all that is negative. That is what this holy month of Ramadan teaches us and is a very significant to our humankind. In short, complete control over one's own self for human harmony and for the good of entire mankind. Of course, there are a lot of medical benefits to this fasting, control of cholesterol, blood pressure, and so many metabolic activities. As you all know, fasting has a lot of benefits. It increases ketone formation, reduces your cholesterol, and reduces your fat in different organs. And anyhow, I'm extremely happy to be here, and it's a very passionate bonding it generates amongst all of us from the people of different faiths in this country. I thank each one of you again wholeheartedly for inviting me here today. Thank you so much.